Good evening, guys. Hope you are doing well. Welcome to MA Consulting. Today, our agenda is to discuss SAP SuccessFactors Implementation Methodology. SAP SuccessFactors Implementation Methodology, like I mean to say, what methodology SAP SuccessFactors is using. Basically, SuccessFactors is using the methodology to implement the project successfully, that is Activate Methodology. Further, we will discuss in this video respectively. The second one is Workbook Configuration. Workbook basically contains the configuration which is pre-delivered by SAP SuccessFactors and required to implement a project and to run your business process effectively. Workbooks are module specific and you will download from Partner Edge portal in the implementation section. The last one is deployment models. Deployment models are mainly four, in which we decide while implementing SAP SuccessFactors which deployment model you want to use to implement SAP SuccessFactors project as a standalone or hybrid solution. I would recommend you to watch this video till the end. If you are new here, please consider to subscribe our channel down below and hit the bell icon to get any future updates. Now let's get started. There are three different SAP SuccessFactors implementation methodologies: SAP Activate Methodology, Partner Methodology, Scrum-based Agile Methodology. SAP Activate Methodology. Many SuccessFactors implementation partners use Activate, an Agile methodology that is standard for SAP cloud implementations, including SuccessFactors and SAP S/4HANA. Actually, SAP Activate methodology begins with a baseline to reach the target processes and configuration for the business needs. Activate methodology can also help teams visualize how the end processes and system look like before the final development is completed. In SAP Activate methodology, there are three iterations or sprint sessions that is allow how the project manager to identify gaps and changes to the design. Each iteration includes a walkthrough of the processes and configuration design within the system. The first iteration occur in the explore phase, as you can see in the diagram. The second and third iteration are the most challenging and big one occur in the realization phase. Because implementation projects are not always clear-cut in terms of activities and phases, some activities can span multiple phases. For example, data migration may begin in the explore phase and conclude in the deploy phase. Now let's explore the Activate methodology with the help of a diagram. In the explore phase, we encounter with the word backlog. The word backlog is a live document and will continuously change during the processes, which is one of the favorite values of agile life cycle. Backlog represents the requirement that should go into the solution. Backlog must be followed by the process of must, should, could, and would. As you can see in the diagram, we just divide the task into the priority and number of days. So which task is on high priority and how many days it would take to complete. The next phase is realize phase, which is the longest one. Here we will do configuration and sprint session with the client side by side. We divide the project into number of smaller chunks and work on chunks. It will be easy for us. We proceed like this way. As you can see in the diagram, for sprint session 1, we have to configure the base functionality of the system first and then walk to the client, and if client asks for more additional requirement, we come back and doing configuration into the system till we succeed to the final configuration and then we perform UAT. Shorter duration cloud implementation must have only one sprint session. Sprint session may depend on the length of the project. The methodology phases are pretty standard. 14 weeks should be more than enough time to implement talent module like succession and development module. SAP Activate methodology is split into 6 phases. Discover phase. This phase includes an agreement between client and consultancy firm kickoff. Prepare phase. This phase includes project preparation, creating the project plan and changes management strategy, enabling the project team and provisioning and setting up of the system. Explore phase. This phase includes validating the base timeline and identifying the gaps through configuration workbooks, changes and configuration values. Realize phase. This phase includes configuring the gaps and changes, conducting walkthrough, migrating data and executing testing and training. Deploy phase. This phase includes conducting the final change management, executing the post-go-live support plan, preparing the cutover and going live. Run phase. All the system is on the PRD server and working smoothly and fine. Now explore Activate methodology with the help of a timeline phase diagram. Here we divide the project into number of weeks and months so we can be sure how many weeks, months specific phase will take to complete. In prepare and explore phase, we work on the workbook and divide them into 2 weeks. Then come up with realize phase. Here we are doing iteration and sprint session side by side. Like for iteration 1, we designated a timeline from 3rd week to 7th week, and in the 8th week we perform a sprint session with the client. Then for the next iteration, we designated a timeline from week 9 to 12, and on the 13th week we are doing a sprint session with the client. For 3rd iteration, we designated a timeline from week 14 to 16 and doing a sprint session with client on week 17. And for week 18 to 19, we may perform UAT user acceptance testing. After the final approval of the UAT from the client, we may proceed to deploy phase. In the 20th week, we may perform go live of the system. SAP SuccessFactors Configuration Workbooks. Workbooks basically contain the configuration which is pre-delivered and are required to implement a specific solution and to run your business processes effectively. Generally speaking, SuccessFactors workbooks are specific for individual modules. In SuccessFactors, like you have a standard template defined like Employee Central module, Recruitment module, and Onboarding, etc. In Explore phase, we walk towards the client and to get more detail about the project, and workbook must be delivered in this phase. The implementation consultant generally guides the customer on how to fill these and then get a sign off to begin the configuration in the system. Once the configuration are completed, the following iterations are held and the respective changes required are tracked in the same workbook itself, and then customer signs off are obtained with each iteration before beginning the configuration changes. Workbooks are required documents that are provided to the customer in a standardized format for each module separately. Now I will go through with the standard workbook configuration file. So this is how the Excel sheet of workbook look like. So you have a lot of Excel configuration workbook file for each and every module, with multiple Excel sheets down below. As you can see, we have legal entity, country specific legal entity, business unit. These are the multiple Excel sheets we have in this workbook file. Where on the basis of workbook requirement gathering happened, workbook are standard like this workbook contain EC related data that you have to collect to establish organization. So you have to configure the organization structure for company. On top of it, you have HR data. First standard object is legal entity, normally called as company. Here you have to mention the list of companies who are working in case of group of companies that you are implementing. For example, if you are going to implement for Almarai, it has multiple companies under it. It has Almarai Saudi Arabia, Almarai Dubai, Almarai Qatar, etc. They all come up different entities, so all you need to be mentioned and maintained under this file. So how the legal entity screen look like, where you will maintain the data for the legal entity. Business unit. Now the second standard object is business unit. Under company we have different business unit like this division. Now the third standard object is division, and under business unit we have different division. Same like department. Now the fourth standard object is department, and under division we have multiple departments. Now location. Locations in which they operate, I mean your location in which legal entity is operating. These are the standard organizational structure of a company that include legal entity, business unit, division, department, location. So we have a number of objects in the bottom. You can see business unit, cost center, department. So basically when we do requirement gathered, what we are supposed to do, we go to extreme right in every sheet. See, like location, it's not all about the list down the names of cities, Sydney, Berlin, Delhi. Location should have a lot of other detail we have to capture. So the start date means from which the date that location is applicable in your business. Whether your business location is going to operate 7th May 2016 or 1st January 2010, in which whatever date your business is going to operate is effective start date, so you have to maintain that. You have to maintain the other detail, the code of every location that will determine your location is in decent way, name of location, status, mean currently your location is active or not. So these are the main detail that you have to maintain in the location object. Okay, this is how the standard location screen look like. In the requirement gathering period, you will show these to client, customer, and ask whether these are fine or you want to add some more field that they want to capture or remove, relabel mandatory, non-mandatory of the fields. In case of you want to capture the department data field, click on department like this. Here in this place you can see fields, and in the bottom you can add the custom field as per your requirement. We have one custom field with the name of cust, c-u-s-t, and you will maintain the data in this screen like this. That's it. You can get the configuration workbook file from partner edge portal in the implementation section. Now the question is, where are the configuration workbook located in SAP SuccessFactors? You can download workbook from partner edge portal. The other question is, can anyone download it, or it's just partner has to access? No, only a certified consultant with active S user ID connected to its partner company, then you can able to download workbook from partner edge portal. SAP SuccessFactors deployment model. SAP SuccessFactors has four deployment model: talent hybrid, side by side, core hybrid, and full cloud HCM, all of which are shown in the figure down below. As you can see, the pictorial representation of SAP deployment model. Employee Central uses only core hybrid, side by side, and full cloud HCM deployment model. The talent hybrid deployment model isn't used by Employee Central because only the talent modules are used rather than the human resource information system HRIS Employee Central. Talent hybrid, SF without EC and only talent module with SAP HCM system. Side by side, SF with talent module and EC, and for running payroll and time management we use SAP HCM. Core hybrid, SF with EC for major function related to employee data and organizational data, and talent modules, and for running payroll and time management. Sometimes we use time management in here, or sometimes not. We use SAP HCM. Full cloud HCM, SF with EC for major function related to employee data and organizational data, talent modules, and time management running in EC. Means all we do in EC, just only for payroll we refer to SAP HCM. Thank you. Don't forget to like and subscribe our channel.